In this video, we will continue to develop our skills in calculating dosages and converting units to dimensional analysis. Let's begin the first problem. We have an order of 0.25 grams of this intended drug. Notice how the measurement is written on the label as 100 milligrams per milliliter. So we could just write that off to the side for our own visual sake. So let's begin converting. So we have 0.25 grams, but we need to find it in milliliters. So then we would first convert grams into milligrams. And then for milligrams, we can convert it into milliliters. Once we do our calculations, we find out that the grams cancel out, the milligrams cancel out as well, and we are left with 2.5 milliliters. Next up, we have an order of 75 milligrams of gentamicin. But notice that this time, it's labeled as 40 milligrams per milliliter. So we could just write it like this. And let's begin converting. Once we do the calculations, the milligrams cancel out, and we are now left with milliliters. So after plugging in our calculator, we get 1.875 milliliters. Notice that our number is greater than 1. If we recall our rules for rounding, our number, which is greater than 1 milliliter, should be rounded to the tenth place. So, we would then rewrite this number to be as 1.9 milliliters. And that would be our final answer. The next part of the problem involves looking at the syringe. If we look carefully, it looks like the increments go up by 1, assuming that the very first tick mark is 0. So then we would just count off to 1.9. This is where 1.5 is, roughly. If we count upwards, we have 1.6, 1.7, 1.8, and 1.9 would be right around here. And we would just color this in. This time it's going to be a little bit different. So we do have our usual order as 0.075 milligrams. However, the measurement this time will be in tablets. So make sure to write your final answer as tablets. Also, our intended measurements can also be found here as 0.5 milligrams in tablets. So we could just write it as 0.5 milligrams. And now we can proceed to convert. And then we would get 1.5 at the end. But make sure to label it as tablets, as this is what the dosage calls for. And on this problem, we have to identify first how to measure this. So it's in 4 milligrams per milliliter, and our order is in 1.5 milligrams. So let's convert. So let's convert. Identify first how to measure this. So it's in 4 milligrams per milliliter, and our order is in 1.5 milligrams. So let's convert. There are 4 milligrams according to this in 1 milliliter. Now it gives us 0.375 milliliters. But notice that this number is smaller than 1. And because of our rules of rounding, we would have to round to the hundredths place. So this number would end up looking as 0.38 milliliters. In this next problem, our order is 0.25 grams. But also we should notice that it's labeled as 350 milligrams per milliliter. And now we proceed to convert. And in 1 gram, there is 1,000 milligrams. And now there's in 350 milligrams are in 1 milliliter. So grams cancel out, milligrams cancel out, and we are left with 0.714 milliliters. But notice that the number is less than 1, so this number proceeds to be, according to our rules of rounding, 0.71 milliliters. The next part of the problem is filling in the syringe. So we could say that this is where 0.5 is. And we can somewhat estimate where 0.71 would be. So we would count this as being 0.6 and 0.7. So right around here where 0.7 is. Maybe a little bit more. But then we could then just color it in. And say it's 0.71. In this next problem, they give us an order of 750 units this time. So it's in a different measurement. Notice how it says that there is 1,000 units per milliliter, implying that our answer, final answer, is going to be in milliliters. So we proceed to convert. So we have 750 units. And there are 1,000 units in 1 milliliter. So then we, once we do the calculations, these cancel out, and our answer comes out being 0.75 milliliters. According to our rules of rounding, our answer is fine just the way it is. So now let's take a look at the syringe. Notice how the increments are very much different compared to the other syringes that we had before. So 0.6 is clearly marked out right here. So we can just identify where 0.75 is. So here we have 0.6, this is where 0.65 would be, 0.7, 0.75 would be just right here. And then we just proceed to color that in. And we are good to go, on to the next problem. This next problem is much more different. This time we have order of 2 different drugs. And we need to be able to combine both of them in a way that both meets their required measurements. So we can begin with the first one, convert the first one. So in 1 milliliter, there are 75 milligrams. So then those would be able to cancel out. We'd have a number, but we're also going to add it with the second drug, which we will also convert, and there are 50 milligrams of this and 1 milliliter. So the milligrams will cancel out and we both have answers in milliliters. So once we do our calculations, the first number comes out being as 0.8 667, and our second number in milliliters, of course, so that being 0.5 milliliters. And then our final answer would be 1.367 milliliters. And remembering our rules of decimal places, our final answer will indeed be 1.4 milliliters. And let's proceed to find that on our syringe here. Here we have 1.5, and 1.4 will just be a little bit short of that. So 1.4 is right here. And we are done. Okay, so we have an order of 40 milligrams of this drug, and our measurement would be 20 milligrams per 5 milliliters. So now we're going to convert. So 40 milligrams are in 5 milliliters. So reduce, we would have 10 milliliters in the end. And that is our final answer. And on to the next problem. So for this problem, we have an order of 0.1 grams. And here we are given that our measurement should be in milliliters. So then we would just write this as here. And then, in 1 gram, there's 1,000 milligrams. And for our intended drug, there are 400 milligrams in 1 milliliter. And our final answer comes out being 0.25. And that is all set for our rules of rounding, since it's less than 1. And on to the next problem. So here's our order, and here is our measurement. So we need 30 grams to be converted into milliliters. So I have 10 grams in 15 milliliters. Those cancel out, and we are left with 45 milliliters. Here in this one, we have 40 milligrams, and we are given that per every milliliter, there is 30 milligrams. So we would proceed to find the number of milliliters that result from 40 milligrams. So here we have 30 milligrams in every milliliter. And then when once our calculations are done, we have 1.3 milliliters afterwards. In this problem, we are given an order of 0.25 milligrams, but the measurement here comes in tablets this time. So be careful with that, and make sure that your answer be written as tablets. Equals 0.05 milligrams. So now we would proceed to convert that. So we have 0.25 milligrams. And we have 0.05 milligrams in 1 tablet. Milligrams cancel out, and at the end we have a total of 5 tablets. And also make a note that it is specifically for itching, just for notation purposes. In this next one, we have an order of 7 milligrams. This one is a little bit hard to look at because it's pretty blurry, but we can at least tell that in 1 milliliter there are 5 milligrams. So we can proceed to use that information. And then our result is 1.4 milligrams. And this one, so we have an order of grams, but our measurement is in milliliters. So let's proceed to find our answer in milliliters. So we have 0.5 grams. Before finding the milliliters, we need to convert grams into milligrams. And there are 1,000 milligrams in 1 gram. And from here, we will say 375 milligrams are in 5 milliliters. So then the grams can cancel out, the milligrams can cancel out, and our final answer will be left in milliliters. So once we do all our calculations, we find out that we get 2,500 over 375. And then we can further reduce that and get 6.7 milliliters. So here we have our order of 200 milligrams. And notice that our measurement is 125 milligrams per 5 milliliters. So then our answer will be in milliliters. So we begin with our 200 milligrams. And just convert that. There are 125 milligrams in 5 milliliters. So then the milligrams would cancel out. And we would be left with 8 milliliters. And that is our final answer. And in this problem, we have an order of 75 milligrams. And notice here that they highlight for us the measurement that we are supposed to use. So let's proceed to convert. There are 100 milligrams in 1 milliliter. And that would get us 0.75 milliliters. And according to rules of rounding, that is indeed our final answer. This picture may be a little bit hard to see, but it says that our measurement is 50 milligrams per 5 milliliters. And our order is 100 milligrams. So we proceed to convert those 100 milligrams with 50 milligrams being in 5 milliliters. And our answer will be in milliliters, and we get 10 milliliters. And for this problem, we can just ignore this part just for the sake of time. So then our actual order is 500 milligrams. And this is our measurement. So then we will convert the 500 milligrams. Because there are 200 milligrams in 5 milliliters. These cancel out. And then we are left with 12.5 milliliters. And that is it. We don't need to worry about the second part here. That's just extraneous. And that is it. That is the end of the nuts. Hopefully this was able to help you.